What's up, everybody? Welcome. Well, today I'm working on fixing some bugs, preparing for another beta update tonight. And the first thing I got to do is test out the Steam controller. So I got all my settings, everything's done with the Steam controller. I'm really happy with this. So something that has to be done is play the game for 15 minutes so that Steam will let me upload the controller config. It doesn't let you do that unless you played the controller config for 15 minutes, even if you make the tiniest little change. So, where is that? Oh, there it is. Set a little timer here. I'm playing, right? I launched from Steam. Set a timer for 15 minutes. All right, let's do this. Okay, so I've got haptic feedback set up, so so basically the D-pad-y things on the Steam controller. They can basically do directions or buttons, and also got it set up so there's what's up, Lime? How you doing, Lime? What's up, man? Also, there's different bindings for the there's different action set for the menu versus the regular controls. Why is it going? Okay, I already got to make one change. I don't know what happened here. What's up, Catch the Bear? Hello. So it's like the menu controls are really, really glitchy. I think I know what's going on. You can set them to be this is what was happening yesterday with the D-pads, with the haptic pads or whatever they are. Whatever you want to call these things right here. The menu controls are a little glitchy. I think it might be it already has an interruptible off. It's a regular press. Maybe I'll turn haptic intensity off. That's weird. I thought turning it interruptible off was what fixed it yesterday. Yeah, Steam controller support. This Steam controller support? I thought this would take a day. I'm like, oh, this should be pretty easy. But it's taken the entire week. So I'm kind of like, wah, wah. There's so much other stuff I wanted to get done this week. But it's not going to have time to do it. But at least I got the Steam controller done. Oh, yeah. Getting one would really help. Yeah. You really got to test it. Because there's... Well, you'd actually... you can work with around it. You don't have to actually use the Steam controller natively. You can actually set up. You can actually go into your game right now and set up a Steam controller binding. Actually, I think you would need a Steam controller to do it, but yeah, you don't actually have to implement it in your game to get it to work. Like, you can bind it using regular controller bindings, but that's the only advantage I see to actually supporting it natively is that you basically can officially say that you support the Steam controller. I don't know. I'm not exactly quite sure on it. Let's see if the menu controls are a little better this time. They were really glitchy there for a minute.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think they do. Oh yeah, it's still doing it. It's really, really glitchy. Fixed this yesterday with the other controls. All right, well, I guess we've got to turn on controller verbosity. And skip menu. I guess I've got to turn off permadeath. So, Lime, how you been, man? Oh no! These controls are broken again. Oh my god, what the fuck? Oh, tell me it's just I have to restart Steam. Jesus, man, this is like something it's like last night I got into some magical, like just changed a setting in Steam, like for the Steam controller, and all of a sudden it stopped doing this crazy buggy issue. Shit. Still does it. What the fuck? Let's just hope I can stumble across whatever setting causes it to fix itself again. Christmas was great, man. How about you? We opened presents, went to some friend's house. It was a good day. So all I did last time to fix this was turn interruptible off. What's up, Bishni? Yeah, still working on the Steam. I just freaking had all this working, and then all of a sudden I launched the stream, launched Steam, and it's just all of a sudden not working again. And now I'm just like fiddling with options to try and get it to work again. It's so buggy. What's up, Wild Chat? Yeah, I'm just about to play the game if I can get this to work. So I think the bug has to do with this. I don't know what happens, but if you set up your interruptibles to on and then back to off, I think it works. Let's find out. Or maybe if I export the config, that might be it. I don't know. You got a fancy mechanical keyboard? Right on. Okay, let's just do this again. Once. Get done. Hopefully that fixed it. Wait, did I export? Hold on, I gotta export. What's up, Rocket? Did I do this? No. Okay, let's try saving the binding again. Dude, this is like the buggiest software. You never know when something you do is just gonna break it. Even though you didn't change anything. God. Alright, let's see if it works now. Shit. My God, what the fuck? It was working all fine the whole day, and ever since last night. What's up, Cropper? Welcome to stream, man. Oh, we're missing some haptic intensity here. Maybe this is the problem. Oh, I already turned that off on those. Yeah, Ishii, that's the one. Yep. What do I do? I don't know. I'm gonna try resetting the controller config again. All right, if I go browse configs. There goes 15 minutes. Fucking with this bug again. Bugs in other people's software really, really bother me. Man. Well, I made a boss chat bot called Gerald. Who's based on the AI in Event Zero. Sweet. You can talk to it? Right on. That's awesome, Lime. Go make it read write. Maybe export it again. Oh, I just did that. Let's see if it works this time. Yeah, just send me an email so I remember to do that. Sometimes I have to like go manually upgrade it and stuff. Oh my god, what? What? Maybe if I unplug the controller and plug it back in. All right, Lime, see you, man. Stream, man.
Okay, I see the tap. I don't want to be on the camera.
Especially when it was working like all day. Fuck. What the fuck? Yeah, this isn't the first time this has happened. This is what my week's been like. Yeah, you get access to the beta as soon as I send you an email. So I have to be off the stream to do that. I can't just get into my Steam keys right now, because everybody will see them. Okay. So somehow I fixed it last night by like turning on and off these settings. Mm-hmm. Let's just set all these to low. And interruptible on. It's like I have no idea what it is in their software that's causing this shitty ass bug to happen. So I just have to randomly freaking try different bullshit combinations until something just magically works. Yeah, New Year's is usually crazy. Crazy party. Okay, so now I'll go back and try and undo those bullshit settings I just changed, like change it to interruptible off, haptics off. Hope it works. What the hell is this saying?
Mm-hmm.
Cross your fingers. I give up. What the hell? Like, oh yeah, I'm all done with Steam controllers, and all of a sudden, wham, you're not done with Steam controllers? Because this shit's all fucked up again. You have no idea why. Even resetting your settings doesn't do anything. Wait a minute. What if it's the freaking power? Because it didn't happen when I was sitting down last night, and it happens when I'm standing up working like this. Turning off power completely. I'm running only on my laptop's battery. Maybe I'll take this power cord out completely. Let's completely shut down Steam. Plug the controller back in. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do next if this doesn't work. Great idea, Rocket. The best idea ever. Okay, there's absolutely no power going into my laptop right now. Oh my god, it works. It works. Holy shit. Completely works now. Okay. Just as a little experiment, if I turn the power back on, this is so weird. Okay, there's the power's plugged back in. Still working. Hold on, now I'm gonna turn the power back on. Alright, power's back on to the laptop. Holy shit, now it's broken again! This is the weirdest shit ever. If I'm plugged into, if my laptop is plugged in with this power cord, not that power cord, but this power cord, the Steam controller is all messed up. Go figure. I don't know why. Okay. I think what's happening is this is a haptic feedback device, right? Haptic feedback devices work by sending a power signal through your finger, right? So it has to, like, the power goes from the haptic, the capacitive sensors into your finger, through your finger, and then back into the capacitive sensor. So if there's something going on with the power for my laptop, like, I'm gonna unplug my power right now. I'm not even unplugging the power for the whole computer or anything. And now it's completely working again. Oh my god, what the hell? This is so, dude. This is so weird. What's up, Pedro? Well, shit, well, now I know what it is. Okay, and if I'll turn on, I'm gonna turn on the light now. Yeah, now it's perfectly fine. Everything's fine. Dude, it's so weird. If my laptop is plugged in, the Steam controller is all glitchy. But only if my laptop's plugged into this power source, not that power source. Holy crap, I think it might be this. This power panel, this power strip right here. Maybe this power strip is just old. Holy shit. Oh, I'm so glad I figured that out. I thought it was Steam, but it wasn't Steam. That always pissed me off so bad. Okay, we'll turn off controller verbosity. Okay, last experiment. I'm gonna try the theory out let's go back to this and turn that analog emulation back to what it was. Make sure all these are how they were. Off. Go delete this config. Export it again. Let's make sure that setting got actually set, because it's happened before where it doesn't. Advanced settings, base, advanced, additional. Okay, cool. Looks like I reset that. See what's changed here. I'm gonna reset that actually. Shit. Didn't take. Do it again. Steve just crashed. Oh man, this is the kind of day I'm having. God, I like never want to see a Steam controller again. Let's do this again. There, now it's loaded. Good, still loaded. Oh, it's almost finished. It's almost finished. Nothing modified. Yes. Yes. Oh, it's back to normal. All right. Okay, so now I can play with that particular Steam profile for that controller with confidence. Okay, so let me just test one last thing here. I've still got my laptop unplugged. I'm gonna play. Okay, with the laptop unplugged. Okay, I'm gonna plug it back in. It's getting a few glitches here and there. Yeah, okay, so it's glitchy. Okay, now I'm gonna completely turn off my power strips. Now I'm just gonna plug in my laptop directly into the power rather than into this power strip. Alright, my laptop's plugged in directly into the power rather than... Is it working or not? I can hardly tell. It's not as bad, but I feel like there's been a few glitches. I want to know definitively, but it's weird. Like, there's like less glitches if I plug it straight into the power over here. No, it's definitely doing it. Yeah, it's definitely doing it. Okay, so it's not my power strip either. It's like this, maybe this orange extension cord. Okay, last test. I'm gonna try undoing my power cord from the extension cord, or my laptop's power, and go straight into the outlet rather than the extension cord. Okay.
Yeah, I'm still streaming, babe.
Come on. Nice rocket. It's cool. Is that a little cardboard box it's in? That's so rad. Okay, so this test, I've got, instead of using the extension cord, I'm plugging my laptop in through its power cord straight into the wall outlet. This is the most fucked up, weird electricity issue. So it's this extension cord, this orange extension cord. I wonder if it's just the fact that the electricity has to go from the whole wall through the extension cord, and by the time it gets to this stuff, it becomes, I don't know, a little bit weaker. Pedro, are you talking about Songbringer? Because it's not early access. So that might be it. You might still be able to share early access games. Songbringer is not for sale at all. There's no early access. It's just not for sale yet. Okay, that works. This completely works now. Alright, shit. What the hell? I can't believe this. This is the weirdest issue. I'm gonna plug my power back in now. What a relief to figure this out, though. Seriously. So, for future reference, if anybody's ever experiencing a Steam controller that's just going haywire when you press the D-pads, the haptic things, it might be your power source. Yeah, at least I know what the problem is now. Okay, let's just, one last time, I want to make sure that the Steam controller still works now, because I changed the power outlet that I'm actually using. Is there sound? Oh yeah. rumble though. Oh no! It's doing it again. Oh my god, it's doing it again. Okay, well, that means that maybe it's this power up. Is it this power outlet? Is it the fact that this whole outlet now is drawn? Wait, what if I turn off this power now? No, it's doing it still. Wow. Okay, if I go back to the other power outlet. What's up, guys? Adzo, Ponish. Oh, you had it set up with PS4? Yeah, this is a little different. What's up, Kier? Okay, so this time I'm trying the power outlet which was working just a second ago. Okay. Plug the power back in. Have I ever a chair? Yes, I do. You see, if you can see over there, I sit in a chair for most of the day. It's not a chair, I sit on a drum throne. Okay, so, oh, it's still doing it. Okay, well, that solves it though. So, okay, it's not my extension cord. It's not my power strips. It's just that wall outlet. If my laptop is plugged into freaking that wall outlet, it will cause, and my Steam controller's plugged in, it will cause the haptic feedback to be all glitchy. So I basically just have to run the game today without the laptop plugged in. Oh, Jesus Christ, this is the weirdest shit. But it's electricity. If somebody understood electricity, they could explain to me what's going on. But I think what's going on is that the haptic feedbacks have capacitive sensors, and the capacitive sensor is getting a little overloaded or something. That's why it's causing it to send a 1 and sometimes a 0. And it's just doing that glitchiness. See that? Super glitchy, right? But if I unplug the laptop, it's perfectly fine. Son of a bitch. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I don't know. Well, okay, so that's an interesting question, Poe. I have it plugged in for most of the day when I work. I'm sitting over there in that corner. And it's never done it to me over there. So it's something to do with that freaking outlet. All right, so, okay. No electrician skills. I wish. All right, so I'm gonna have to play for 15 minutes now. I've been playing for a little bit, but I'm gonna play for 15 minutes just so that Steam will allow me to upload this controller config. Whoops. Okay, so I'm gonna start a new game. What world seed should I do? Someone to give me 6 letters. First person to give me 6 letters, I'll do their seed. Whatever it is. Feel free to be wild here. So how long did it take me to solve that little electricity issue? Like 45 minutes? Man. Just gotta let it go. Just gotta relax, breathe deep. Cheese it is. So I'm playing the game with the Steam controller and the haptic today. It's my first time ever doing this. If you're hearing wind, the sound of wind, that's just because my laptop's like burning hot right now. It's hard for it to stream the whole, like my whole entire screen is being encoded every single, you know, fraction of a second. And it's also trying to run a game at that resolution. So that's why my laptop heats up so much. My laptop's about to take off. See, but you should be able to hear the sound of the game too. So let me know if the sound of the game is too low. Man, I just gotta breathe deep. That bug was getting to me, man. That's the first like hardware bug that seemed like a software bug. It's not a software bug. It wasn't Steam's fault. It could actually be Steam's fault for making the Steam controller like so sensitive. Oh good, the mic isn't picking that up very much. Good. So if anybody's just figuring, like, joining the stream, you're like, what's this game? It's a Songbringer. It's like Zelda 1, but procedurally generated and sci-fi. So that six-letter world seed I just gave it, that generates the whole world off that those six letters. And if I wanted to play a different world, I just enter six different letters. If I want to play the same world again, do a speed run, or, you know, whatever, just enter the same six letters. You'll know where everything is in that world. Did you mean a cheese run? Exactly. I'm in a cheese run. Get the diamond. Yeah. Cheese, the official. If you want a speed run, you gotta do World Seed Cheese. Okay, so one of the things I'm doing during this little 15-minute run or whatever is I'm checking out how the haptic controls work on the how they feel, right? Because I set it so that the B button is usually your bombs, and so the haptic has like A, B, Y, and X on there. So the B button and the Y button are for your like consumable items. So I set those so they require a long press. So you have to tap it hold it for a second before it actually engages that button. But if you just use the regular buttons, and the analog stick on the Steam controller, they work immediately. It's just the haptic ones I'm talking about. So far this is pretty good. You can actually get plenty of good control with the haptics. I still want to do another secret in this room. What's up, Luke? No, this is not a self-made engine. You could say it's kind of its own engine because the game itself is like 80,000 lines of code. But no, I'm actually using an engine called Cocos 2DX. It's a C++ game engine. Oh, what's up, Cave? She might be able to go in here and find the top hat. Yeah, the haptic one has a hold activator, right, exactly. So the A button, which is your sword, is like a regular, you don't have to hold it. But the B button, which is usually your bombs, that one requires you to hold it just for a second. So I'm trying to make sure that is dialed in just perfectly before I upload this to Steam. Yeah, the config options are pretty great. Other than it being kind of buggy, at least on Mac it's pretty buggy. But yeah, the power you have as a player is really actually pretty neat with the Steam controller. Gotta work on those shadows. Thanks, Luke. What's this? Can't afford any of this stuff yet. I saw some pillars up here. There might be a level up this way. Oh, what's up, dude? Oh, did I set my timer for 15 minutes? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, they are? Well, that's good to know. Yeah. It doesn't work at all on Linux either right now, but on Mac, yeah, it's on Mac. It's getting better, I guess. Let's see if the level's right here. Oh, it might not be. Yeah, thanks, Matthew. That's a big compliment. You'll notice a lot of key differences, though, between this game and Hyperlight Drifter. Hyperlight has a completely different gameplay feel to it. This game has bombs, and you can throw your top hat, and like you can. There's a lot more things you can do. But that said, Hyperlight Drifter's artwork is sick. It's so awesome. It levels back that way. Yeah, the lighting is shaders, and they are GLSL, yes. Whoops, wrong way. What's up, Candy Popper? Sorry, I called you Candy Popper because of the spelling. How long? 2 years. 2 years and it's not finished yet. One thing about the Steam controller is you've got to like remember where your thumb is when it comes to pressing a lot of buttons and stuff. So that's weird. It like took a minute to activate that. Thank you, Jalen. I've been doing art like this for about 2 or 3 years. I just got started making pixel art. This is my first game I've ever made the pixel art for, or any of the art for. I've worked in other teams and stuff like that. I've been working on games for about 20 years now, but always in teams. So this is my first ever solo game. So I do the art, the music, the sound, and programming. It's hard to get used to. Yeah, nice. I'm sure it's probably really awesome for some games, huh? And I'm trying to force myself to use the haptics today because I just want to make sure that they are really, really good. Oh, there he is. Get him before he... Yes. Wow, man. Sorry, guys. I was really stressed out there for a minute because I was this whole weird issue with electricity. Basically, I figured out that if you plug your Steam controller into a weird power outlet, you're gonna have problems. Okay, so this was kind of a short dungeon. I'm actually gonna, should I go through it? Yeah, let's just go, well, let's get some more bombs. But we got bombs. Let's do it right. Okay, yeah, you gotta hold down the button for a second. Yeah, any controller, any random normal controller works fine already. It's just the Steam controller that I'm adding support for right now. And just a note, like, if you pre-order the $16 version, that gets you the game when it comes out, when it's finished. That's going to be in the future in 2017. But if you pre-order the $32 version, that gets you the game right now, so it'll be sent to Steam code immediately. Oh, Bullseye Pie, what's up, man? How you been? Thanks for saying happy holidays. I hope yours were great, too. Seems really easy because he is. He's really easy. But also because I use bombs. So bombs do a lot of damage. If you don't use bombs right there, that fight takes a little bit longer. Been busy as hell? Right on. Cool, man. What you been busy with? What you been doing? Trying out the sensitivity there on these guys. So I set these so they're a short pull. Actually engages, so I think that feels pretty good. Nice short pull. Make it be a little longer. Thanks, man. Nobu Fat Revenge? Nice! Right on. How's it been? Controls are working pretty well, actually. It's got a separate action set for the menu too. So Steam in their documentation was really saying that's important. Oh, sweet. Nice, we're done. It's been 15 minutes, but I'll play the next dungeon. I'll play at least one more dungeon before I quit, or before I go and fix some bugs. Nice, right on. Xbox One. Empty flask, but I don't have enough to fill it up. Oh, don't have enough. Where's this next level? Oh, right, it's right over there. Nice, you're talking to Sony? Right, yeah. Microsoft program. You're saying it's kind of restrictive? Oh, it's harder compared to Microsoft's. Me too, Poe. I love pixel art. Oh, it's way over that way. So I do gotta get to fixing some bugs on this stream. I guess I already fixed a really big bug. That was like such a psychologically... Like, it made me so... I'm so anxious. It like hurt my brain to fix that. Figure that out. So it wasn't even a bug fix. It wasn't even a bug. It's just a power outlet. What's up with that? Why does it take a second sometimes? Along with a hot cup of coffee on a rainy day? Nice! Matthew, it's about, like, it depends on how thorough you are. If you're really, really fast, you're gonna beat the game in, like, 3 to 4 hours? If you're not really fast, but if you're really fast, you'd beat it faster than that. But like, if you're doing it at a normal pace, here's like some good stats for you. Here's some people that have beat the game. 4 hours. I guess it's only shown 9 of these. Wait, what's the score based? Maybe this one has some more. Oh, it does, but it doesn't. These are like. There were some on here that were like 8 hours. If you're being really, really thorough, it's going to take you probably like 8 hours or more to beat this game and get all the secrets and stuff. There's a ton of secrets. All right, Tygo. What's up, Raidu? In fact, this might be a secret right here. See, I think this might be a secret wall. Oh no, not a secret wall. It could be, wait. Nope, not a secret at all. Damn. Lucky. Thank you, Matthew. Appreciate it. No spoilers. Am I spoiling? I don't mean to spoil. Tell me if I'm spoiling. Let me know. Not watching? Alright. Whoa, Jazzle! I might die here. Oh, I totally died right away. Oh, anyways, I gotta get back to fixing bugs, so that's gonna be it. So, yeah, I'm gonna get to fixing some bugs now. Change into a little bit of a different mode of the stream. So, okay. I gotta go save that controller config. There's no official release date yet. It's just 2017 sometime. Okay, so controller config. I just played that for more than 15 minutes, so Steam should allow me to save it. Yes. It does. Before 2020. All right. You save that. That's 829. Five, three, five, two, six, eight. 829-535-268. It's only nine letters. 1-829-535-268. Yeah. Okay. All right, that's done. Yay! We got a controller config. I'm happy with. Tested it out. Steam's happy with it. That I played it for 15 minutes. All right, time to get to fix some other bugs here. Yeah, I don't know if you can or not. It hasn't been set to be the official config yet. So there's some settings I have in on Steam where I'll need to set that. And then I also have to go and upload this code so that you can actually play it with the Steam controller. So you shouldn't, if you can access my config right now, it probably won't work. All right. So first bug on the list. This wider elevator trigger area. Let's do this one first. Man, that whole problem earlier on the stream today just like freaking got me so like I still have to breathe. Man, it's wild. Okay, something's going on with the triggers for the elevators. All right, so I want to go back to, let's see, what world is this going to be? It's going to be Xanadu. I want to go to like a certain level. Let's just go to level one. What changed in interfaces? Oh, thank God, I can finally run the game outside of Steam. I can use debugging tools again. Oh, this is so great. So great having the Steam controller done. Almost, gotta still upload it. Okay, so I'm gonna save here. And okay, I want to take off level one. So it's going to do... Okay, cool. It doesn't appear on that end. Good to know. It will tonight, once it's all uploaded. What's up, Pithlix? Thank you, man. I'm glad you're a huge fan. Thanks for saying that, man. I appreciate you saying that. Especially with the day I'm having. Damn. Okay, so if I stop there, it just goes right on, but... Hold on. Oh. Wow. Okay, so it doesn't... Oh, I think because the story system resets the player's idle timer. Yeah, there it is. If it's waiting for input or the timer is greater than zero, it zeros out the idle duration, and that's why he can't activate. That. Okay, so the thing that's going on here is when you step on these elevators, it requires the player to come to rest and be idle for just a fraction of a second, like 0.2 seconds. But there's a little zoom in happening. It zooms in and then it zooms out and there's a little bit of story delay. It's basically not allowing you to... It's not allowing the idle timer to tick during that time. But I want that because for certain types of story system elements, like it needs to have the idle duration reset. For example, if you're talking to somebody, if you're talking to another NPC or something and some dialogue is happening, you don't want the player to get bored and then do the bored idle timer thing. So, I guess a compromise there would be to take off the timer bit. So, it does reset your idle duration if you're waiting for input, but not if it just has a timer. Okay, let's see if that fixes it. How many languages do I know? If you're talking about like English, like spoken languages, I know English and a little Spanish, but I think you mean programming languages. I know lots of them, but mostly C++ is the one I'm most familiar with. C and C++ and Objective-C. But not C#. I don't know C#. I don't really know Java, but I can figure out Java. I know PHP and Bash, I guess you could say. A few others. Okay, so this time it should be able to trigger this, but not while it's zoomed. Oh yeah, it does while it's zoomed. That's fine. Okay. That's good. Okay, so now it's not trapping the player or whatever. So now we need to turn off Brutus. Oh, it already doesn't have Brutus. That's cool. See, I don't know that. That's Swedish, right? Swedish? Wait. What's that mean? How did you learn to make games that you make? Yeah, I know that that's Swedish, but I don't know what you're saying. How did I learn to make games? I just did. You know what I mean? These days, it's a lot easier to learn to make games. Back when I learned, it was way hard because there was no internet. There was no YouTube. All we had were books. So I learned from books. I learned the C language. And I learned how to make games from a book about game development. All right. So we need to turn off the Brutus. What is Brutus? Brutus gives you the flask quest. So let's turn off the flask. But he also gives you the compass zero. So we need to turn that off. I think that should enable Brutus to appear now. All right, each knee, see you, man. Have a good one. Have a great night. Rocket. Okay, I also got to turn off. What? Why is he guiding? Oh, probably because. No? What's he doing? What? It's weird. Why was zero even appearing? Yeah. Sorry. Hell, what is he doing? Where is he taking me? Why would he? What? Does, if it guides the Vel, if you have Vel zero, super bombs, yes. Oh, it just gives you, oh, if I have the super bombs at all. Okay, so that logic is correct. So I need to not have the super bombs for this all to happen. You want to learn to make a decent game? Really nice. You've been trying different engines? Oh yeah, Cocos is kind of hard to find good tutorials for. Oh sweet. Okay, there's Brutus. All right, so if I sit here, I just sit here for a while. Actually, let me turn on Story of Verbosity too. Trying to get rid of that freaking anxiety from that bug, man. All right, cool. So it's waiting for input. We got four different actions it's going to run. It does the dialogue, then the item, and then this delay. So while I'm sitting here, he shouldn't, after 13 seconds goes by, he'll become bored, or he would become bored if there wasn't a dialogue. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And good, he's not bored. So yeah, it's doing that. Okay, so now, given 13 seconds later, he should become bored. Yeah, there he goes. He's bored now. Okay, I think that's a pretty good compromise. Let me just confirm this. And add a little note. There we go. Okay. Ah, good, good, good. Okay, so let's test that one last time. So I run up here. Good, it activates it even though there was a story zoom going on. That's good. Okay, I'm trying to think, is there any other situations where you would want to keep the idle duration from happening? I don't think so. I think this is going to work. All right. Another thing is I want to make sure that the area for the elevator was wide enough right now. You can't see it there. Oh, it is wide enough. Okay, so it totally didn't have anything to do with how wide it was. It was just that. Okay. So that's a good little bug fix. Just a one-liner. All right, good. One bug down, 103 to go. What do you use to make games? I use lots of software. I use Visual Studio when I'm on Windows. I use Xcode on a Mac. I use GCC and the terminal on Linux. I use Vim for editing code. I use Photoshop for making all the artwork. I use Ableton for making music. I use Massive for making sound effects and music as well. Okay. So the next thing, do I want to finish the death sequence? I guess so. Yeah, I need to make this death sequence a little smarter. So the delay plus the interface, there's a problem with that. So to illustrate that potential issue, It's in phase death. And basically what phase death does is it does this little fade. It lets the player do his animation, and then it does a fade. Okay, so let's see it just working normally. So we'll die. Yeah, and it totally works fine. But if I set a delay that's too long, I think. Like if the delay is really long. Or wait, if the delay is more than, or the fade duration, what's that? I think if it's just if the delay is like set too long. If the delay is set too long, I think it'll just, it won't even run the interface or something. So I want to make this more rock solid. Because if like on some chance that maybe the player, their system's running really slow or something like that, I don't want this to be based on time. I want it to be based on something more rock solid. Like a Boolean variable or something. Oh, it still worked. Really? I swear I was doing something the other day where this didn't work. There it goes. Oh, wait, no. It worked again. What? Maybe if it's a really short delay? What the hell was it that caused this to happen the other day? Was I debugging? That's fine too. Damn it. What the hell? I had this set to like. This is 1.6 right now. I think it was like 1.9 or 2. Maybe the fade duration was longer. There it goes. That's it. Okay, that's what's happening. If the fade duration is a little bit longer, it does that. It just like exits this interface immediately. I think what might be happening is the interface hasn't even been shown yet. See if that fixes it. Nice, it worked! Yay! So that fixes the bug because it's not ticking the interface until it knows it's actually created the death interface. Okay, that's good enough. I'm not gonna redo this whole thing. So what was that before? The value was 2.2. Check that once again, just to make sure. Thank you. pretty good. That part of that bug's fixed. Okay, now I want to use the smart text alignment. Because if we set this to German, the text is going to be kind of aligned a lot differently. And I've got some code which aligns text based on how big it is. Oops. So let's change this to German. Yeah, see that Fortson is huge and Beenden. This is all messed up. Okay, first of all, the words need to be shrunken a little bit. And then second of all, they need to be aligned based on how wide they are. Okay, so that's going to be an interface's death. No, not an im's death. Oh, there we go, interface's death, nice. So for each one of these, it needs to do... Where is it? Where is it? It's coming, Rido. It will. We'll eventually have it. Chinese, Korean, Japanese. Those are, yeah. So I just have to get some people to translate it to that, and I also have to draw the fonts. But there'll be, yeah. There's plans for those. Oh, wait a minute. These should already have their text shrunken. Why not? Why don't they? There is going to be a lot of drawing. Black Iron, what's up, man? How you been? What about Pig Latin? I know, it's so... Jeez, why don't we have Pig Latin yet? Okay, so what is the spacing? It should be automatically spacing these out and making them tighter spacing. What did it get? Spacing 0. What? Oh, I think I know why. It's not counting scale. Here's the suggest spacing function. I don't think this cares about scale right now, and it totally should. Oh, geez, that's totally the problem. Klingon? You want to make a game like Mario? Nice, man. You can do it. Okay, so this needs to be label times gets, whoops, label dot get scale. This is why I use Vim, because Xcode is slow. Yeah, of course, man. You can do anything you want. It'll take time, but if you enjoy what you do, what is it? What is time that you enjoy? It's just fun time. I enjoy most of the things I do with game development. Bugs can kind of suck. As you guys saw earlier on today's stream. Okay, so let's check out this spacing. Okay, so this label's size, this content size, is 101, but it's scale X. Oh, it's still not big enough? What's the win size? Still not doing it. Oh, because this thing hasn't got its, I get it. It hasn't been scaled yet. Oh man, and that would totally do different glitching for scaled. Okay, I shouldn't do it this way. This is a bad way to do it. Okay, because there's a weird bug in Cocos 2DX. If you start do this, like if you change your BM font during an action, it can crash sometimes. So what I want to do is after it's set its scale like this, let's just always change its spacing and make sure it's not, doesn't have a glitch action. Wait, so does it have a glitch action right now? This is the question. Compiling kit. What? Yeah, it does have a... does have a glitch action. Alright, so we need to cancel the glitch action. And then call kit change spacing. Spacing delta -1. Yeah, tiled is great. Oh, Regathian, what's up, man? That's a little better. Oh, it crashed. Okay, so font glitch must not be the thing that it runs. Or c.onCreate is called before it actually calls create. No, that can't be it. It might be just glitch, so I think it's a function called alien glitch. No. Whoops. There it is. All right, set action font glitch. Oh, this is it. Why didn't that work? Oh, because whenever you change your choice. Okay, so you can't just stop the font action glitch because it's going to run it again whenever you move your cursor. Oh, wait a minute. What if I just set... Okay, instead of doing all this... What if I did set scale 2 on the Y, but like... 1.5 on the X. You're doing some late night fiddling, right on? Behavior trees, sweet dude. Yeah, man, nice. That's awesome. Were you the one that told me to implement behavior trees back in the day? Somebody did. It was a really great suggestion. That looks all squished. But it's almost fitting on the screen now. Yeah, really awesome. Such a great way to not have to code all your AI. You don't have to recompile your game when you change the AI at all. I think the smarter way to do this is actually to make it so, it's because this looks weird. I want to make it so that each interface choice has a... You're working on Zelda game too? Nice, man. Oh, you control the player that way. Nice. Right on. Source interfaces. Choice. Okay, so each choice is now going to have a float spacing. Nice, he does a spin attack with the sequence. Cool. So if spacing is 0 by default, what will trigger Yeah, right on. It does the whole animation pipeline. That's sweet, dude. Cool. What language are you working in? What are you writing your game in? Oh, C sharp, right on. Let's make an enum. Default spacing. Ah, shit. Let's just keep it at 0 and then make it so the interface. What? Wait, where were Salad, what's up, man? I guess that's choice doesn't have a default. Yeah, how you doing, man? So this menu continue, I want this choice to have a negative one. C dot spacing equals negative one at least. Same thing here. And then I want to go to where it has suggest spacing. Yes, I did get the Steam controller stuff worked out. It was the craziest thing, dude. I spent like 45 minutes so frustrated and cursing on this stream earlier today, trying to figure, remember that whole glitchy issue from yesterday? So I got off the stream and I sat down in my other place I work at, right over there in that corner. And I thought, oh, I just changed some settings in Steam and all of a sudden it magically worked. So I was blaming it on Steam's client that it was that the glitch was happening, right? And then today, after a whole like 12 hours of coding, everything was working beautifully. Everything was so awesome. I was like, yes, I'm ready to go test it one final time and then check it into Steam, upload it my controller interface, my controller config to Steam. And then I get on the stream. What's the first thing that happens? It gets all glitchy again. I'm all, what the hell? I was like, seriously, for 45 whole minutes, I was like wanting to like just bang my head against the wall. But guess what it was? I actually want you to guess. You gotta try and guess. Try and guess what it was. It was painful, I'll tell you that. It wasn't really stupid. I mean, I guess you can kind of think it was really stupid. It was. A space in auto spacing? No. A fence post error? No. You guys are gonna trip when I tell you what it actually was. No, it wasn't. It's not that it was stupid on my part or anybody's part or Steam's part or. You wrote a number in Occult? No. Polling? No, it wasn't polling either. You guys are gonna trip. This is what it was. Okay, after 45 minutes, I'm like, oh my god, what if it's... Because, okay, so this workstation right here, I've had these weird issues with, right? Sometimes I'll, like, touch my mouse, for example, and I'll hear clicking noises. And so what it turned out to be was the power outlet. It was the freaking power outlet. I went and unplugged my computer, right? So that, actually, right now, it's still not even plugged in. So, yeah, this is the issue. If a Steam controller is plugged into a laptop in wired mode, not wireless, but like if your power outlet has some weird juju going on and your computer is plugged in and your Steam controller is plugged in, the haptic feedback things on the Steam controller will go glitchy as hell, just glitched out. But so that's why it works perfectly fine when I was in that corner plugged into that power outlet. But if I'm plugged into this power outlet, it's got glitches all the hell. And you know what? I tried everything. I unplugged. I turned off my power strip. I turned off my other power strip. I unplugged it from the extension cord. I narrowed it down all the way to just that wall outlet. No matter what, if you use that wall outlet, it gets the glitches. I know. I don't know why it doesn't. I think it's just a slight power fluctuation surge. I don't know. I don't know what the hell it is. It's so weird. And I know, and I, this like power strip I'm plugged into has its own surge protection. So it's got, I've got it running through a surge protector. It's not like it's surging huge amounts of electricity or something. Like an electrician could probably tell me what the hell is wrong with it. But at this point, I'm just like, shit, I just decided to run the rest of the stream without the laptop even plugged in. It could be an issue. It's not our house, but we should probably have our landlord like come and take a look at that, because that could be bad. It's a good point. It could be it could cause a fire or something weird at some point. Man, it's a good point. But dang, how long have I been streaming? I'm tired already. Oh yeah, I'm already over 2 hours. No, balls. Well, actually, I guess it could be the controller itself, but it happens to me with other weird stuff too, like mouses. Like my old, I had an Apple Mighty Mouse. It's the capacitive sensors, right? Anything with a capacitive sensor will do it. So it's that my old Mighty Mouse did it. It had this weird clicking noise, and then this like, the Steam controller has a weird issue. Parents had some new lights. And you saw her found a faulty wiring. Whoa. Yeah, wiring was done poorly. That's probably what this is. It could have caused the fire. Whoa. Yeah, we should have him take a look at that. Man. Well, yeah, so I'm tired, guys. I got to take a break. That whole, like, solving that little issue with the Steam controller and the power outlet really drained me. I was, like, seriously cursing pretty hard. So, anyways, I got to get going. But I hope you all have a great New Year's. Have fun. I'm not going to be streaming until, like, Monday or something, because we're going on a little trip this weekend. Yes, the foo hit the fan. Power surges on the ground. Yeah, they could reach the USB port, right? Yeah. So, anyways, have a great night, you guys. Yeah, thanks for staying high, and we'll see y'all like Monday-ish. So, have a good one, guys.